Hi, this is Vanessa Joy here, and I want to show you just a few quick Lightroom tips that I use in order to edit my photos. You might know I do same day edits, so I need to edit in Lightroom quickly. So here we go. I just have four pictures here, and I'm going to show you just how I quickly edited these. They do have an import setting on them already that all of my pictures do when they come into Lightroom. And you can just see a little bit of what that is over here. The exposure is down just a smidge, contrast is down, highlights are down to make sure I'm not blowing out the dress. Shadows come up, whites come up, so the dress does look nice and white. And the blacks stay the same. I do have the clarity lowered to about minus 10. Just helps smooth out the skin a little bit. It's subtle, but I do like it. The vibrance has come up to 36 and the saturation to minus 5. Now, recently, somebody asked me about skin tones and what I do to get an even skin tone. And I'm in New Jersey, so skin tones normally look a little something more like this, and everybody has a nice fake tan. So I try to eliminate that by coming into this part of Lightroom here by adjusting the saturation and luminance of the reds, yellows, and oranges. Now, I already have a little bit of the settings here where I've lowered the saturation just a little bit for the orange and red, and then the luminance has come up for the orange and red. And if I turn this off here, you're gonna see just a little bit of a difference in the skin tone. It's not drastic, but it definitely helps. Now, this bride does not have a ton of skin tone issues, but another way you could do this is by clicking on the selector here, coming over to her skin tone, try to find like a mid range, and I'm on the luminance right now, so if I just click and drag up, it's going to brighten that color. And if I click over to the saturation, click and drag down, we're going to lower that color. And you don't want to go too much, otherwise, you know, she looks like she's coming from the morgue. But you know, right about, let's see, right about maybe there, isn't so bad. So that helps a little bit with the skin tones. And then of course, doing any other adjustments that you want to do to the actual photo. I just bumped up the contrast a little bit and the exposure slightly. Now I do every once in a while when I have a bride, especially like this one, she's got these great gorgeous eyes, I'm going to come in here and just brighten them a little bit. So if you come over to the top and you have your local adjustments here, and I have the Lightroom retouching toolkit, which will let me go to eyes green and click, and I'm just going to brighten up the color in the eyes just a little bit, nothing crazy. And if I wanted to, I could also go to my beauty brush here and just kind of soften her skin a little bit. You don't want to do too much because this is essentially just blurring, but if you do just a little bit, it's not so bad. All right, so that's fine. I think that's perfect. Zoom back out. So there is my before upon import and then after. Now, so same exact thing applies when I'm doing pictures with the bride and groom. You know, it has my import setting on here. I'm just going to tweak a little bit, probably lower the blacks, bring up the contrast, definitely need to adjust my tilt. I can't take a straight picture to save my life. And then we do have a little bit of the orange going on here, so I'm just gonna click on my selector tool, find a spot on her, lower the saturation a little bit, come to my luminance, same thing, bump up the luminance to brighten the skin, and there we go. To me, that looks a heck of a lot better. Just do quick before and after. And you have to know your client too. You know, maybe the client wants to look a little bit more tan, so they might like this. You might not want to do so much of an adjustment, but for me and my purposes, that looks good right there. Gonna lower the blacks a little bit more. Perfect. So that looks good. So I'm going to go to the next one. I'm just going to click previous. This is the exact same scenario, so it's going to be fairly similar. I don't have as much flare, so I'm just going to pull my blacks up again. And then we've got this one right here. Same exact thing. Gonna bump up the blacks because not quite as much as the other one. Now, one more thing, little trick. I come to my gradient tool here and I use my little sun flare setting, which you can see over here is just bringing up the temperature to 57 and lowering the contrast, which is what your sun flare does. And then I just bring that over as if the sun is flaring through over there. Go to new and then go to a blur brush and do the same thing, and it just softens the image. I don't want to do it too much because then you're going to get them all blurry, so I'm going to bring that back. But I could do that even down here if I really wanted to get crazy with the blurring, but I don't, so we're going to get rid of that. And that's it. I'm just going to export these, and now I have four finished files in, well, just 5 minutes. I will see you guys next time. Oh, you thought I went away, but I didn't. I'm going to show you this very last trick that I use in Photoshop, because as much as I love Lightroom, there are things that Lightroom just doesn't do. So I do usually bring my photos here into Photoshop to give it one last thing. I have a set of actions called Far Green Country Actions. You can get them on breatheyourpassion.com. And I have a sort of combo action here that combines the Get Faded Film and the Midtone Color and Pop action. So I'm just going to run that. It also adds a little bit of cooling on there, just because typically it does make the picture a little bit warm. So I run that action and then I just adjust a little bit. I don't want it to look too faded, but that looks pretty good to me. And now I want this to happen to all of the photos. So instead of clicking over to the next photo, running the action again, waiting that, 10 seconds for the actions to run, all I have to do is use a handy dandy script I have. Come over here, I'm going to highlight all of the layers, which are the actions that I ran. Come up to File, Scripts, and Duplicate to All Documents. It's a great script you can also get on breatheyourpassion.com. And now when I go through, you can see the actions are applied to all of them. And of course you might want to adjust a little bit, like this one here would look nice maybe with a little bit more contrast, bumping up a little bit more of the midtones here, and that looks great. And the rest are probably fine since those were just taken seconds after each other. And then I come back to my scripts, same set of scripts that has the duplicate to all documents script, and go to save as JPEG and close. And it's going to flatten all the images, save them as JPEGs, and close them. And it's not writing over your original file, it is making a copy of them, which you are able to see right here. So you can see all the originals on top and then all the bottom, all of the ones that have been Photoshopped. So just one last little tiny little thing that I do that does make a good amount of difference here. Make sure that you hit subscribe on the YouTube channel below so you can see more of these videos. And this is Vanessa here on Adorama TV with Breathe Your Passion. I will see you next time.